Hello guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to open password protected zip files without password. So before jumping onto the tutorial, I would like to show you a quick demo of the complexity in this password retrieval process. So first visit lpassword, the link will be in the description, and let me set the password length to 7 characters, and let me set the numbers as well as upper and lower cases checkboxes checked. So now you can see that there is a huge number of possible combinations with the given inputs, so finding the right password would be a hard process. So please note that there is no one-step solution to unlock your zip file password, and this is the best chance you have got. So let's get started. First, download the software from the link given in the description, and once installed, launch the application. Now browse your zip file by clicking on the browse button. Open the zip file, and now you can see that there are several methods for the search. I would recommend you to run the dictionary search attack first. So what this is it tries to open your zip files with a password that's already present in a predefined list, and these words would usually be pronounceable, readable words. And let me check this mixed words option and click start. Make sure to go through all the options and make appropriate choices, and you can see that the password has been detected, and click on copy, click OK, and let me show it to you. Now you can successfully unlock it. Click close, and let me show you the next demo where the password is a little more difficult with some symbols and lower and upper cases together. So let me browse the next one. Click open, and let me choose the brute force attack. Okay, if you know nothing about the password, make sure to select the brute force attack. Make sure to check the appropriate choices. Click on digits, uppercases, underscores, and what these separators are the special characters like exclamation marks, slashes, and other special characters. Make sure to check them too. Set the password length. Let me set to 10 characters and starting from 1. And you can set the option to save the search progress, and it would be a very handy tool. And click on start. You can see the progress of the search right below the dialog. So now we have our 2% completed. So this process may take a while, so please be patient. Now the password has been successfully detected. Let's copy it and click OK and paste it. Remove the file name, which is automatically being copied, and hit OK. Voila, you can see that it has been successfully unlocked. And let's recap. So if you got a file, you should first try the dictionary search method, and if it fails, then you can proceed with the brute force attack. And make sure you provide all the details that you know in the software, and that's pretty much it. So make sure to hit the subscribe button if you think this video helped you. Leave a like, and thank you.